Hatshaep-Sutuk Betas, and I'm a student teacher, a master teacher, are there any questions? We just go for starters.
Yes, I have a question. I'm trying my best to word this right. How can Africans learn the Wapoli?
How can Africans learn the Wapoli?
Yeah,
the Wapoli or the Wapoli?
The Wapoli? Yeah.
Well, for one, I mean, you can ask any Wapolians worldwide. We're all over Facebook, you know what I'm saying? So, you just pick one, so to speak. That's first of all. You know, if they have any questions, you can, you know, ask them to walk in. There's also our famous question and answer classes. We have them in almost every city, major city and state, nationwide. So if they, you know, want to learn about Wapoli or the Wapoli, they can always come to a, you know, their local beer and ask questions, indulge, learn about the culture. That's pretty much it, you know. I mean, in reference to how can they learn about Wapoli.
Okay. Why is it so difficult for the Wapians to fully understand or accept the Wapoli?
Why is it so difficult for the Wapians to?
Yes.
Well, a couple reasons. One of the reasons that my master teacher had explained to us was because we're still under the spell of vision. And it's when you're in Western society, living in the Western world, it's difficult sometimes for some people to fully merge themselves within the culture and within Wapoli. A lot of people still don't fully understand it. You know what I'm saying? It takes a lot of discipline, it takes a lot of studying, it takes a lot of sacrifice. You know what I'm saying? So, which is some things that's just something people, a lot of people are not willing to give up. So it's much easier for a lot of people to, you know, just claim it than live it, so to speak. You know, a lot of people with our master teacher, you know, still getting locked away, it's easier for people to kind of like carry it how they want and carry it that's, you know, carry it in a way that's more feasible for them. You know, Wapoli is a lifestyle. It takes a lot of work. And in living in Western society, I mean, it can be difficult. I can see how it can be difficult. On top of the fact that we do live, I mean, we're under the spell of division still. You know, and Bob had explained to us a lot of things that we're up against as New Orleans. He explained to us that, you know, there are people, you know, in a lot of different places and forces that's working towards keeping us from elevating and succeeding. So being that as it may, you know, that's an extra thing that people have to fight to accept and fully live on top of, you know, different internal battles that they're dealing with. So with all those different forces and all those different things that they have to take into consideration, that they have to live with, it's hard for people, you know, it really is. So, but the best, all we can do is just do our part. You know, once we learn how to do our part and do our best, you know, to just live and walk as best we can and take the direction, you know, that our teacher Panabagan has given us, then it'll be, you know, we'll be a step ahead. We'll be on our way to getting where it is that we need to, you know, to get.
So, okay.
You're welcome.
I appreciate it. Okay, so, in the past, what were ways that we used to keep our youth?
I've never been on the land. You know, I always hear stories of different things that we, you know, did on the land as it pertains to our youth. We always, and from things that I did here and things, you know, like pictures and audios and videos and things, like it was always something going on. And even after the land, we did that, you know. And I know in Georgia, it was really, really heavy with children being involved in doing things. So a lot of things that we did, like, you know, our children were our focal point to a lot of different things because, you know, they're our future. So they're going to carry the WAPU on for, you know, the generations to come. So a lot of things that we did, I mean, we just spoke with the children and found out what it was that they wanted to do. What was it that made them, you know, what was fun to them. And we took that and we incorporated, you know, into different things and activities for them. Not to mention our, you know, cultural holidays that, you know, mostly are very much, you know, geared towards children and teaching them our culture, you know, through that way, through those ways. So it's pretty easy to do, you know what I'm saying? We just got to come together and do it. It takes a lot, especially from us sisters, you know, because we have the children, you know, we're the caretakers and the first teachers of the children. So it's going to take us, you know, to really, really enforce that and incorporate that. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, any ideas is great. You know, we always take different, you know, ideas on things to do for the children. Other than that, it's like the sky's the limit. It's like so many different things. You know, and just incorporating Wu and Wapu and keeping that in mind every single time we do, deal with the children. Or, you know, make sure the WAPU is a factor in it at all times. It really got right. So we pretty much do, you know, whatever. So, did that answer your question?
Yeah.
Okay. Any other questions?